Zoom H4N is a professional audio recorder that is ideal for recording things such as interviews, meetings, auditions, and music performances. Along with the recorder, you should also find an AC power adapter, USB cable, windscreen, plastic shell 16GB SD card, and a removable handle. If any of these are missing, please let a DMC staff member know before leaving with it. Please note that batteries are not included. You must supply your own two AA batteries if you wish to not be tethered to an electrical socket. You have two choices when it comes to supplying power to the H4N, the power adapter or the batteries. To use the AC adapter, plug it into any regular electrical socket and connect the DC power connector to the input located on the bottom between the two XLR inputs. To use batteries, flip the H4N over and slide the battery cover off to insert your two AA batteries and then reattach the cover. A pair of batteries will last about 4 hours. Power on the H4N by holding down the power slider switch on the left side of the recorder for about 3 seconds. The SD card slot is located on the right side of the device. Insert the card with the label facing up and the cut corner on the right side facing in towards the device. To remove the card, push down on it until it pops up. It is always a good idea to start off with a clean SD card. To format the SD card, press the menu button on the right side and use the scroll wheel above it to scroll down to SD card. Push in on the wheel to select SD card, then scroll to and select format, and then select yes. When completed, you will return to the main screen and should see no data below the time code. There are a few different options to record audio. You can use the built-in mics, the two inputs on the bottom, or a mix of the internal mic and one of the inputs. To use the built-in mic, select the mic button on the left under input. To use the XLR input, select the 1 and 2 under input. If the recorder is set to a mode other than stereo, push the menu button on the side and use a scroll wheel to scroll down to mode. Select mode by pushing in on the scroll wheel, then scroll down to stereo and select that. Be sure to check the audio input level before recording. Good audible level should fall between -12 dB and -6 dB. If you pass -6, it can become distorted and anything below -24 will be too quiet. To check your levels, press the record button once. It will begin flashing and you will see the levels of each input on the screen. The bar for each input should go about 3/4 of the way across the screen for normal volume, which is between -12 and -6 dB. You can adjust the levels of an input by selecting the input with the front buttons and then using the record level toggle on the right side of the device to increase or decrease the volume. To select a recording mode, press 4 on the front panel. There are two main audio recording formats that we use on the H4N. Wave 44.1 kHz is uncompressed, has a broader frequency range, and is archival quality. It will give you about 24 hours of record time on a 16GB SD card. MP3 is the other major format we use. The difference is MP3 is compressed, which means it uses less space and provides a longer amount of record time. With MP3, the higher the bitrate, the better the quality. The bitrate can range between 48 and 320 kilobits per second. Recording an MP3 will give you about 277 hours of record time on a 16GB SD card at 128 kilobits per second. The other thing to check before hitting the record button is the microphone angle of range. The microphones have an adjustable range of between 90 and 120 degrees. They can be adjusted by twisting the individual microphones between the 90 and 120 degree markings on the sides. The 90 degree angle is useful for smaller settings such as interviews. The 120 degree angle is useful for larger events such as conferences and concerts. Once you have set up your SD card, inputs, levels, and the modes, you are ready to hit record. To do so, press the record button on the front of the device. Since you should have been in preview mode before, the record button should go from flashing to solid red. If you are not in preview mode, you'll need to push the record button a second time to engage recording. Be sure to constantly monitor your levels using the bars on the LCD screen and through headphones if possible. The easiest way to transfer your files onto your computer is by SD card. Remove the SD card from the right side of the device. Insert the card into the SD card slot on your computer. Open Finder on your Mac or computer on your PC and navigate to the SD card. The files will be in the folder labeled with the channel mode you used, which typically is stereo. To transfer by USB, connect the USB cable to the recorder and your computer. USB Select should appear on the H4N screen. Select Storage and press down on the jog dial. The recorder will now appear as another external drive in your Finder on your Mac or computer on your PC.